In Hillsborough, a handful of doctors and nurses have been told to stay home for 2 weeks after potential contact with a patient who tested positive for coronavirus. It's just a precaution.
And we learned tonight dozens of employees at Kaiser Permanente who came in contact with those patients are being told to self-quarantine at home.
But for those hospital workers, there may be more to the story. I exchanged emails with one of the healthcare workers under quarantine. They wanted to remain anonymous, so no names. The employee had concerns because for several days, that patient was in a room with no isolation procedures. The worker felt like there weren't enough protections for the employees. They also said the hospital should have done a better job notifying those workers that they may have been exposed.
Kaiser Permanente released a long statement. In it, the healthcare provider said it's following CDC guidelines and working with the Oregon Health Authority to implement procedures and protocols that'll reduce staff impacts should we begin treating additional patients. Similar concerns have been raised elsewhere around the country. The LA Times reported anxiety is mounting among U.S. health workers on the front lines of the coronavirus. Healthcare providers in Northern California and Washington have contracted coronavirus from patients, which is not that surprising. Medical workers on the front lines of an epidemic often make up a disproportionate number of cases because of their close contact with sick patients. Which presents an interesting and important question. Is enough being done to protect these doctors and nurses in the workplace, like a hospital?
My name is Adrian Inghouse. I'm a registered nurse and the president of the Oregon Federation of Nurses and Health Professionals.
The union representing many of those healthcare workers in Hillsborough says it's become increasingly challenging to monitor the shifting recommendations for treating coronavirus.
The CDC is changing and changing and changing what we need.
Union leaders are talking with their members, medical workers, to ensure they have the equipment and the resources they need, but admit it's still very early.
Our entire career, we've been walking into rooms where we didn't know what we were walking into. That's the nature of our work.
These doctors and nurses rely on safety guidelines from the federal government for treating patients and to prevent exposure to the virus among themselves and their coworkers.
There's been a lot of focus on equipment, masks and medical supplies necessary to combat the coronavirus, but the unions representing health workers say we should also be talking about staffing levels. If enough people on the front lines get sick and have to stay home, somebody's got to fill in.